Okay guys, good morning. Got part two here for the sway bar end link replacement. I did get the sway bar this morning. Actually, my mom did, so thanks mom. But yeah, there's a new sway bar. All the hardware and whatnot. And I was able to get the bolt out of the old one, as you can see. Once I figured out it was right, I cut it out. And instead of using the new, I'm not even sure what you call that, the sleeve for in there. What? Come on, Tiger, I'm trying to do something. So anyways, we're just going to reuse that and stick it on. Okay, now that I got rid of all my distractions, I'm going to reuse the sleeve on this. I know you guys can't see anything over there, but... it comes with a new... it's almost like a bronze-looking sleeve. It's the color of these washers down here. So it's probably something coated, I don't know. Alright, I just ground all the old rubber off, and I'm going to obviously use the new rubber that came in the kit. I don't know if you guys can tell, but it's raining here today. Raining pretty good, too, actually. So, now I got rid of all my distractions. Yep, she's gone now. I'll get cracking with this and put it on. Just a little installation tip here. Put the bottom end through the sway bar first. Because otherwise you'll never be able to get that in there if you put the top bolt in first. Then put the bolt through and find the hole and push it in up there. You actually have to push down the sway bar a little bit. This is the first time I've ever actually done one of these, so I'm learning as I go along here. I'll have to go grab a wrench for the bottom nut there. I don't even know what it is. Okay, while I'm remembering, I guess the camera won't focus on it, but anyways, the price of the new sway bar is $31.99 before tax. With tax, it's $33.91. But we had like a coupon to go with it, so it ended up only being like $21 or something like that dollars. I don't remember offhand. I just have the receipt there. This nut from the bottom of the sway bar is 14 millimeter. Is it going to focus? No, it is not. Anyways, it's 14 millimeter, so we'll get down there and I think you just snug it up. I think I'll just show you guys once it's done. I don't think I'll videotape doing all this, because most of it's pretty self-explanatory, but... Okay guys, there it is. All installed. I'm going to leave you guys with one more helpful installation tip here. If I get the light to hang somewhere. There you go. Whenever you go to tighten this up, if I can get the wrench on, put a wrench out here on the leaf spring side and let it, let it lay on the leaf spring. That way your hands are free, both your hands are free for the other side in order to tighten it down. Just make sure it doesn't come, it doesn't slip off there and fall and hit you on the head and knock you out or something. That would be bad news. And yeah, that's a successful sway bar end link change. Now what actually happened at the parts store was they thought they had two of these in stock, but whenever I got there and took it out of the package, it's just the bushings, like the rubber down there and the rubber up top there. So the guy said he was going to send an email to the company and tell them it's misrepresented, doesn't include the actual sway bar end link. So the sway bar end link, like I said, is like $30. The repair kit's like either $8.98 or $9 or something like that, which, you know, if I still would have had the lower end of this sway bar end link down here, that would have worked. So, but anyway, there you go, guys. And before I leave this, at the top, it's an 18 millimeter bolt. At least that's what mine is. You could really put any bolt that fits snugly inside that sleeve in there. It really doesn't have to be 18 millimeter. Obviously, that's just the head size. I didn't measure the bolt while I was out. Down here at the bottom, it's 14 millimeter. Just tighten the nut up until both bushings are snug in the sway bar, we'll call it. Want them to be tight and no play to them. And as far as I know, that's it. I'm not really going to take you guys on a test drive or anything. I will put the link to part one in the description down below. I guess down here it is. Sort of. Back here, like, for me. Anyways, I'll put the link in the description for part one, and I'll do the same for part one. I'll put the link in the description for part two, so you guys don't have to be hunting all over for it, you know, so they're right in a row. Anyways, thanks for watching, guys, and I'll see you later.